do to save it. Mm-hmm. Help could be on the way. And some of them that have lost homes might be able to salvage something out of this deal, of this money's millions of dollars that's now been approved to come in. Sure. Penny, give your phone number again, please.
Sure. My phone number again is area code 302-275-4709. Or you can email me at Dryden, D-R-Y-D-E-N, P as in Paul, at AOL.com.
Okay, Penny, I want to thank you for coming in and sharing that valuable information. And anytime, if I got an open show that you feel something you want to further push and or come back and do this at a later date, feel free to give me a holler and we'll get it worked out. Let me say also, before I go, I would be remiss if I didn't say also that I have agreed to share time with Ms. Allison Lang of Each One Teach One. Allison does a fantastic job with the work she does in the area of prevention. You see her here on our program, Reality Check. Allison is located in the Rose Hill Community Center building there on, is it Lampson Lane? I think it is. Right next to the Boys and Girls Club there. So feel free to check in. Send a shout out to Sheila. She does a fantastic job as a new executive director at the Rose Hill Community Center. Hear a lot of good things about it. My daughter's one of those that pack in that gym. Sheila that does the workout on Mondays and Wednesday nights, and she's trying to get me to come on down. One night I'm gonna surprise you, I'm gonna come in there and get down with them. I hear it's really out of sight. The instructors are fantastic and really make you get a sweat, make you work out. And she says that a lot of her girlfriends are going as well. So again, all the many programs, the senior program, and so many other things that they're doing there. What do you call that dance thing they do now? Not Simba, what do you call that thing? You know what I'm talking about.
Zumba,
some everything out there at the Rose Hill Community Center. Also, they're starting Zumba down at the, in Southbridge, at the Albert Palmer School. Lady brought that to the civic meeting on last week, so we'll be telling you more about that as well. Going to take a short break, let Miss Penny Dryden go, come back and talk to you the remainder of the program. Don't touch that dial. Be right back.
King Center would like to take this opportunity to announce for the benefit of the Wilmington and Newcastle County communities the fact that September has been designated as National Recovery Month. Please join in helping all of us who have programs get the important message out that treatment works. The King Center has taken on, as part of a national campaign, a public relations and community awareness program in which we have put on a billboard campaign promoting treatment works. Our hotline number is 654-3430. Again, that's 654-3430. This effort is to help as many people as possible in our communities to find the proper treatment program. Our goal is to assist them in becoming and remaining drug-free. The King Center has also purchased a large number of t-shirts. These are being distributed to treatment agencies, drug prevention programs, churches, community agencies, and government officials. They all feature treatment works. Please help us spread this vital information so that together we can reduce the dependency on drugs, alcohol, pills, etc. We'll be right back.
Okay, as they're looking for that WHA promo that I have, I want to kind of take you back to last Sunday night at the last part of the program, of which I made some real hard comments about the WHA and the way some things are happening there, and some of my frustrations and things that I had hoped that we would have been down the road by now and have addressed. But things get a little difficult sometimes when things don't go the way you'd like to see them go, and nobody's does all the time. But be it as it may, the fact of the matter is, as chairman of the Housing Authority and talking with the mayor, and we being in agreement to deal some things and do some stuff differently, I'm hell-bent on trying to see how we can get them done with the help of the board and those that are there, and turn the corner on some of these things. I want to talk about that in a moment. I want you to look at this promo. It's something that I did a rest job. I had done. I'll tighten that up, and it'll be a little better next week. A little more information on it. But take a look at this. They have the promo, WHA, and we get that in, and don't touch that dial. I'll be right back. God bless.
Get on the WHA Friendship Train. To join WHA Residents United, call 652-2946. Again, to join WHA Residents United, call 652-2946. This was once the South Bridge Extension. We need more low-income housing rather than tearing them down. To everyone across the nation. Our seniors need to be able to live comfortably in a safe environment. Situation. WHA has 65 residents in this building. Who really owns it now? WHA family units are being demolished, and some are being renovated by Philadelphia, New Jersey contractors. We need to employ our own contractors who will hire our residents and others here locally who are unemployed. Get on the WHA Friendship Train. To join WHA Residents United, call 652-2946. Again, to join WHA Residents United, call 652-2946.
Okay, I wanted you to see that. Again, that's a promo that I'm going to be running. I'll tighten that up. This was a rest job on yesterday, but I wanted to get the billboard campaign and get that tight, of which I'm comfortable with that one, that I've showed you this afternoon from 1 to 2. It's been shown 2-3 times, and again on the 6 o'clock hour here. The Wilmington Housing Authority, get on the friendship train and join us, and I'm asking the residents to come on and roll up your sleeves and let's go back to work as we used to do back in the old days, if you will, and come together as the residents, the seniors in the high rises, the resident councils, and those in the family units, Southbridge, Riverside, the low rises, 201 Poplar Street or 102 Poplar, whichever that address is, because one of those two buildings, which were WHA, one is now, I think, given to Sunday Breakfast Mission on that side of a Second Street. But we still own the other one, have residents in the other one across the street. And our other low rises are Kennedy at 28th and Tatnall, and down at 30th and Tatnall, we have Evans, which is 3 or 4 stories, but they're referred to as low rise units, not like our high rises that are many floors up, as you know, like Compton, like Lincoln, and Lincoln was before it was tore down and now put back. Big question, who really owns Lincoln? What's going on? We owned the Lincoln Tower years and years ago, and WHA owned that. And now, because of a new deal put together with developers, they're now Michael's management, or the developers that end up supposed to be owning the new Lincoln Towers. What happened to the old Lincoln Towers, the land and all that, as we were a part of that agreement, and as we had ownership of that land. I'm getting mixed feedback from different recorder of deeds and license and inspections and other places. Some say we still own it. Some say Michael's owns it or something. It's entangled, and we got to fix it and understand that. Why is that so important? It's important because out of about 80 units or so that are there, 65 of them are WHA residents. So I'm confused. Maybe a very simple explanation. God knows I've been searching for it. I'm looking. I got Mr. Purnell to pull me some information on last week. I haven't looked at it yet, that he put out the front desk for me on Friday. I wanted the resolutions approving that so I can look at the language of the resolutions and whatnot. I got some lawyers I'm talking to about it, both lawyers. Mr. Cliff Hearn now, who's working for the Board of Commissioners, as well as Mr. Barry Willoughby, our longtime attorney at the Housing Authority. And I got them both trying to help me to cut through whatever's going on there or went down and try to understand what happened and how did it end up that way, with us having 65 residents in it. It's a new program that HUD has come out with a few years ago called RAB, I forgot what, resident something something, that allows these private developers to come in to be able to work with housing authorities if they vote to agree and HUD approves, to allow them to do repairs or fix up or whatever, and in the Lincoln case, to be able to tear the old building down and rebuild brand new with the new firehouse attached on the side of that particular building, and usually that causes units for people of low income and seniors when that happens. But nonetheless, it's there. There's an issue of now that we owe a commitment from Housing Authority to be a part of that deal, going back a few years when it was put together, that we owe, the Housing Authority owes $250,000 to the city of Wilmington, was supposed to pay it up long ago and allowed them to be able to redo that ground that was the base. Forgot what they call it. It was the ground to store all them big heavy trucks and cranes and all that, and you're destroying the property and the playground area and all that, and it was supposed to be repaired, put back with some additional equipment and all that, of which it was agreed upon in the tone of $250,000. Don't ask me, don't start me to line. I don't know what's up with that, but I wanna know. I wanna know that and many, many, many other things. As I mentioned last week, for the last two Sundays I rolled by, I seen the contractors from out of town, Philadelphia contractor, I seen the New Jersey contractor over there working and repairing our units after we made some votes and did some things to be helpful to get some of the construction started again. And then lo and behold, we're locked into a deal where it was said that we could not go back out RFP and go to bid, but rather that we had to go forth, since new money has come in to continue the money that ran out. And some, I think it was 57 units in Southbridge, I think that's the quote of the number, had to come to a halt for a good year or so. And now that we, the new board, has supported something as we were asked, trying to understand, but usually last minute, wanted to do the right thing. We look up and we're locked into out-of-town contractors, one from New Jersey with his crew, and another from Philadelphia with his crew. And they're there, out-of-town contractors with out-of-town workers getting our work. And somehow we got to find a way to fix that and to allow our Wilmington and New Castle County contractors to be able to be a part of the work that comes through and by and bid it out by the Wilmington Housing Authority. No ifs, ands, and buts about it. It's something we used to do, and it's something that needs to be fixed and somehow can be fixed, and that's what we're trying to do. The local contractors are hire local people here from the city of Wilmington, hire some of our residents from public housing as laborers, teacher Muskeel on some of those jobs. A lot of them catch on quick, and as a result of that, they're able to go ahead and to find other work or continue to work with these local contractors. So it's a pet peeve of mine. It's a serious concern in other board members, and that's another issue that we're going to be addressing. Also, the service delivery as it relates to our residents when they have complaints, serious complaints, things not so serious, but things that need to be taken care of within a reasonable amount of time that sometimes go on and on and on and on and never seem to get addressed. We got to improve upon our quality of service delivery to our residents. And that's both in the family units, that's both in the high rises. We've got to get a better handle on that. Concern about what appears to me to be top heavy. Whole lot of top folks getting big salaries up at the top and not enough filtering down to fill jobs where they're needed, particularly in the area of maintenance men who get lesser pay, but are desperately needed to make these repairs. A lot of our maintenance people are overworked and work orders just pile up because they just can't seem to get to them in a reasonable amount of time. I don't feel that any of this is unreasonable to expect, unreasonable to want to fix, and to try to roll up our sleeves and work hard as a new board and address these things. The way in which management has been gone and directing the things to be done at the top staff, which is our ED, Mr. Fred Purnell. A lot of these things have been happening year in and year out. And a new board coming in now and is saying, for whatever reason, the old board agreed or allowed these things to happen. We see things that need to be corrected. And we're gonna work very hard, close together. Those of us that see the problem and wanna work on it, of the board, we're gonna be working hard to do that. That's not putting anybody down, that's not trying to just attack anybody. The picture is as real as what it is, and if it is what it is, if it walks like a duck, quacks like a duck, it's a duck. It's a duck, bottom line. And I'm not in any personal battle with Mr. Purnell or anybody. I don't dislike anybody or any of that. It's not personal. It's on the issues of the things that I'm talking about. Residents, W.H.A. Residents United is going to be a very, very hard push issue that I've taken on. I've been thinking about it, alluding to it over the last 4 or 5 months here, that I had something in mind that I wanted to do. And I came up with the idea of putting a name on it, W.H.A. Residents United. I want you folks to work through your resident councils. We got to abide by the rules. They say many times when someone comes to the meeting or says, well, I had a problem, I talked to the manager and they didn't do nothing to this or that. Sometimes the manager may say, you didn't tell me or whatever. And I tell these folks, and we need to preach it and drill it in the heads of everybody that's a resident. You need to fill out an incident report. You need to take that to your manager, take a responsible witness with you that can say, I was there at that point, day and time. ask the manager to sign off on another one that you have or make a copy so that you can verify that you turned it in. Sometimes it does not fall in the lap of the manager, and perhaps they do get passed on when they're legitimate. But again, if they're piling up in the maintenance office, if we don't have maintenance men able to get to those complaints as they pile up, then again, the wheel is broken. The system is broken. It's not working anywhere near as best perhaps some of us feel it can be if we're employing and doing some things differently. So that's the bottom line of where I am. And that's the position that I take. And I'm going to be very aggressive going forward to try to ensure that I give the leadership as chairperson of the Housing Authority and with those board members that support what I think and what I do and want to be helpful, and we kick it around and have a discussion and then we say we're going to address it this way. We're going to go forward to try and make these changes. I'm concerned about policy and procedure, written policy and procedure, and reviewing some of that. I'm concerned about the lease provisions that can allow you to be evicted and the hard letters that come out when someone alleges that you may have done this or that as a resident, a neighbor, or somebody down the street. And the hard tone of the letter scares a lot of our residents, and the language doesn't have to be as it is in some of the letters, as if you're getting ready to be evicted because somebody said you did something. So again, all these things need to be put under the magnifying glass or the microscope. Let's look at them and let's make changes where we must. This last thing that went down on September 4th about a public hearing that dealt with a flat rent increase for our residents and a very serious kind of a problem that kind of frightened some folks. And God knows I didn't know anything about it. I was told later on that because we didn't have a board meeting that there was a package given to us when with a lot of things in the folder. Talking about the hearing, and that was our notice at a special meeting that I called. And I, for one, did not go through the package, got it sitting on my desk, and other board members as well. As I asked them about the hearing, did you get something? Did you know about it? The majority of them that got back to me said no. They said no. Mr. Chairman, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know nothing about no hearing. So they didn't get to look at theirs either. Let me just say, in defense of all of us, we don't work for Wilmington Housing Authority. We put in many volunteer hours, but we don't work for Housing Authority. We get zero for being on this board. So we're not like staff there every day. And I say to Mr. Purnell, he needs to let me know. Give me an email. Call me up when things are important. And I'll make sure we check and we'll know what's going on. Bottom line, we got about 60 people in that meeting and a lot of folks were educated. It's still an issue that will be on the agenda in our board meeting at 6 p.m. in the 400 Walnut Street office on September the 29th. So the issue's not over about rent increase and all that. So you better be alert. Join WHA Residents United 652-2946. Until 9 p.m. tonight, this concludes my program and got some interesting things for you tonight. If we can get these phones going, I might even use the telephone. Having said that, God bless you and hope you continue to have a fantastic day.
Hi. This is Representative Stephanie T. Bolden asking you to take a Bolden step. Re-elect the person committed to making Wilmington and the state of Delaware a better place for all citizens.
Stephanie T. Bolden, your state representative for the 2nd District. Experience, effective, and proven leadership. House Bill 312, restoring judicial discretion in Delaware with regards to concurrent or consecutive sentences. House Bill 417, protecting Delaware seniors from financial fraud. House Bill 167, co-sponsor legislation to ban the box and give ex-offenders a fighting chance at finding employment. Co-sponsor Senate Bill 3 that saved the Port of Wilmington and over 2,200 jobs. Co-sponsor Senate Bill 6, increasing the Delaware minimum wage rate and improving the quality of life for all Delawareans.
Thank you for your support and vote to re-elect me on November 4th.
Paid for by friends of Stephanie T. Bolden for state representative.
Osborne's Auto Repair, serving downtown Wilmington for 30 years. Delaware State certified in auto emissions. We do tune-ups, brakes, air conditioning, all car needs. Stop in and see Ed Osborne or his son, Ed Osborne Jr. That's Osborne's Auto Repair, 658-0377, or visit us on the web at osbornsauto.com. Stop in and see Osborne's.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jay Caldwell speaking, and I'm here to remind you of the big anniversary celebration of the Gospel Ambassadors. Sunday, November the 2nd, at the Ezion Fair Baptist Church, 1400 B Street, Wilmington, Delaware. Our pastor there is Dr. Christopher T. Curry. The doors will open at 5 p.m., program 6 p.m. sharp. Our special guests include this year the world-famous Williams Sisters of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, singing If He Has to Reach Way Down, Jesus Will Pick You Up. Again this year, the Southern Gospel Singer from Washington, D.C. And again this year also, Carol and the New Anointed Stephen Singer from Jersey City, New Jersey. For the first time in our city, Sister Ella Wright and the Spiritual Voices from Bel Air, Maryland. And back again, the fantastic Soulinaires of New York City. Opening up our program will be evangelist Serena Ford, our own Serena Ford from Wilmington, Delaware. Our MCs again this year, Brother George Witcher and Sister Marva Richardson of Channel 28 TV. Advanced donation $20, at the door $22. Seniors and children $18, at the door only. For more information, call 654-7062 or 658-0278, 762-3249. Or sepia cleaner, 656-0700. Dinners will be served at the church. Again, we're going to take off some shoes at the Ezion Fair Baptist Church Sunday, November the 2nd. Meet us there.